Welcome to GemWeb blog. In this video, we are going to discuss about how to create a table using JTable class and its methods. Now, what is mean by JTable? It is a component which is used to create a table. Here in the table, the data can be displayed in two-dimensional format. That means the data can be interpreted in the form of rows and columns. So when you discuss about the package, JTable package has been derived from J component. Now we will see what are the constructors used to construct the table. So these are the different types of constructors available in JTable class to create table. So among this constructor, we have considered this constructor for our demonstration. And then we are going to discuss other constructor in the forthcoming video. Next, we will see how to create a table. Now, this is the constructor we have taken. So, this constructor receives two parameters. One is data, which holds data value, and then heading, which holds the column heading. These two parameters belongs to object class. Now we are going to create this table which contains two column, role and name, and we are going to populate this table with 6 rows. Now this is the coding for this. Now we will enter into the demonstration. So before we start creating the table, now we will look into the basic code. First we have included the necessary package and then we have defined a public class. So inside the public class we have defined the constructor. So inside the constructor, we have included the code for creating a frame and displaying it. Now we will start with the table creation. For this, we have to create a data array of two-dimensional, and then we are creating the single-dimensional column heading variable. Now just we are going to copy paste it. So inside this, we have given the value for 6 rows. Each and every values we have included 2 values, one for role, another for column. Next we are going to include the variable for column heading. So once we have included it, now we are going to create the table JTable. Table equal to new JTable of, first you have to give the data variable data, followed by we have to give the column heading variable as head. Once you finished it, you have to add the component into the container. You can able to add the table directly. Suppose if you are going to create a large size, means you have to view the content by scrolling it up. For this, we are putting the table inside the scroll fan, so that whenever the size of the table goes large, the scroll pen will automatically appended. So we have created the table and we have added into the container. Now we are compiling it and executing it. Now you can able to see the table has appeared on the frame. Next we will look into the different types of methods available in JTable class. First, we will see how to set the height of all the rows in the given table. Set row height is used to set the height of all the cells in the given table. Get row height, whatever has been set, it will extract it. Now, we are going to set the row height of the table as 50, and whatever has been set, we are going to extract it and display it. Now you can able to see the height of the row has changed to 15, and whatever has been set, it is extracted and displayed in the console. Next, if you want to set the height of the specific row, means same set row height method is used, whereas you have to pass two arguments. One is which row you are going to set the height, and second argument, what is the height that you are going to set it. and get row height, here you are going to pass one argument, that is for which row you are going to extract the height. Now we are going to extract the, now we are going to set the height of the first row to 50, and we are going to extract the height of the sixth row, that means index value is 5 for sixth row. Now you can able to see the height of the first row alone has been changed to 50. The remains, the other rows remains as such, and then the height of the sixth row has been extracted and displayed on the console. Next we will see how to set the space between two cells, that means height and the width of the space between the two cells. Set intercell spacing is used to set the space, and get intercell spacing, whatever has been set, it will extract it. For intercell spacing, we are going to give the both height and the width space. So for this, new dimension object has been passed as an argument for set intercell spacing, and whatever has been set, it will extract it and display it. Now you can able to see the space between the cell has been set to 15 column wise and the row wise. Since the height space has been increased, you can't able to view the content. Suppose if you want to view the content, means you can able to increase the row height. I'm increasing to 40 so that you can able to view the content. Now you can able to see the content since the row height has been changed. Next we will see how to set the row margin, that means the space between the cell content and the adjacent row. And get row margin, whatever the space has been set, it will retrieve it. Now we are going to set the space between the cell and the row is 7. Now the space has been set. Now we will see the changes. Now I am increasing to 9. We increase it, the content will slowly disappear. Now you can able to see the content will slowly disappear from us since the space has been increased. Next we will see how to get the number of rows in the given table. Get row count will return the number of rows in the given table. Now 6 rows are available, so it has returned it. Next we will see how to get the number of columns in the given table. Get column count will retrieve the number of columns in the given table. Now you can able to see the number of rows is 6 and number of columns is 2. Next, how to change the value of a particular cell, and also how to retrieve the value of a particular cell. Set value at is used to modify the value of the existing cell. And then get value at, whatever the row and column value that you are passing, it will retrieve the value which is available at that particular position. Now we are going to change the value of a cell at fifth row and second column, and also we are going to extract the value of a cell which is available at first row and first column. Since the index is starting from 00, since the index value is starting from 00, the fifth row is represented by value 4 and second column will be represented by value 1. So mean fifth row 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fifth row, second column, already Sanju has been there, it has been changed to Manju. and then the first one, first column, the values are 001. The value has been extracted and displayed on the console. Next, we are going to look into the methods relevant to cell selection. Suppose if we want to make the row selection, means you can use set row selection allowed method. Get row selection allowed, whatever the method has been, whatever the set value has been set, it will return it. Initially, we are performing the row selection in the J table. Now, if we want to make it as disable, means you have to set the value to false. If it is false, means then we can't able to perform the row wise selection. Now, can't able to perform the row wise selection. Next, how to perform the column wise selection? For the set column selection allowed method is used. Get method, whatever has been set, it will retrieve it. Initially, column selection is not allowed, it is set to false. Now we are making it to true to perform column selection. Now, if you want to select the first column, you can able to select it. If you want to perform second column selection, you can able to perform it. Next, if you want to make both row wise and the column wise selection, if you want to select column wise, you can able to do it. If you want to make row wise, you can able to do using a single method. Set cell selection allowed is used to perform both row selection and the column selection. Now, if you want to select the column wise, you can able to do it. If you want to make row wise, you can able to perform. Means you can able to perform both the operation using single function. Next, we will see how to set the background color for the cells which we have selecting. Set selection background is used to set the background color of the cells which we are selecting it. And get background color, whatever color has been set, it will retrieve it. Now we are going to set the background color of the selected cell as blue. Now we are going to see the background color of the selected cell is blue. Now when we are selecting the cell, you can able to see the background color is changed to blue, and whatever color has been set, it will extract it and display it. Now, if you want to set the foreground color of the selected cell, means set selection foreground is used, and whatever color has been set, it will extract it and display it using get method. Now, we are going to change the foreground color, that means color of the text will be changed to blue color when we are selecting it. Now, when you select the cell, you can able to see the color of the character is changed to blue, and whatever color has been set, it will extract it and display it. Next, we will see how to set the vertical line and the horizontal line. Set show vertical line is used to set the line which is available vertically. Get show vertical line, whether we have set the vertical line or not. Now we are going to make it as false, so that the lines which is available vertically in the given table will not be visible for the user. Now you can see that the vertical line is disappear from the given table. Next, how to set the horizontal line? Set show horizontal line is used to set the horizontal line, and get show horizontal line, whatever we have set it, it will extract it and display it. Now we are going to make it as false, so that it will not appear on the given table. Next, we will see how to set the grid lines around the cell in the given table. Initially, the lines will be available in the given table. Now, if you don't want the line, you can set it to false using set show grid method. Now we look into it. So now you can able to see there is no lines around the cells in the given table. Next we will see how to change the color of the grid lines in the given table. So using set grid color is used to set the color of the lines around the cells, and grid color, whatever the color you have set it, it will display it. Now you can able to see the line color has been changed to blue color. Thank you.